there's been a lot of talk about John Bolton's new book, and some journalists have read it, and they've isolated the turning point where Bolton basically starts to hate Trump. Now, you know, a lot of people on the Democratic side are using the Bolton book to, like, burn Trump and be like, see, Bolton came out against him. As if that means anything. As if that's like, well, obviously Trump is wrong in this, and Freudian slip, Bolton is correct. You're about to see that his motives are even worse than anybody could have guessed. Actually, that's not fair. I guessed it. Probably many of you guessed it, but at least in terms of all the people who make up the dominant voice in mainstream media, they're oblivious as to how bad and wrong and terrible Bolton's motives really are. So, this is from his book. The font is a little small here, and I'm going to start, it's kind of near the bottom of the page, it's like halfway down through that second paragraph. But this is the most important part, and why Bolton turned on Trump. Trump came on the line, perhaps 7:20, I was slowly crossing the Roosevelt Bridge across the Potomac, to say he had decided to call the strikes off because they were not proportionate. 150-1, he said, and I thought perhaps he was referring to the number of missiles we might fire compared to the one Iranian missile that had brought down the Global Hawk, which is a drone. Instead, Trump said he had been told by someone unnamed there might be 150 Iranian casualties. Quote, too many body bags, said Trump, which he was not willing to risk for an unmanned drone. Not proportionate, he said again. Pompeo tried to reason with him, but he wasn't having it. Saying we could always strike later, Trump cut the discussion off, repeating that he didn't want to have a lot of body bags on television. I tried to change his mind, but I got nowhere. I said I was nearing the White House and would come to the Oval Office when I arrived. In my government experience, this was the most irrational thing I ever witnessed any president do. It called to mind Kelly's question to me, what would happen if we ever got into a real crisis with Trump as president? Well, we now had one, and Trump had behaved bizarrely, just as Kelly had feared. So in other words, Bolton was down to be in the Trump administration and help him with his agenda until Trump called off an attack on Iran because he feared that there would be way too many civilian casualties. Bolton is saying it's the most irrational thing he's ever heard from a president because Trump didn't want to attack Iran and have 150 dead people because they had shot down a U.S. drone. He said, it's not proportionate. I can't do that. Now, later on, Trump did kill Qasem Soleimani. Okay? Let's understand that, which I'm totally against. It's insane. It brought us to the brink of another new hot war. That's absurd, ridiculous, and it's dangerous, playing with fire. But a little bit earlier, weeks earlier, Trump was going to do an attack that would have killed more people and Qasem Soleimani, and he said, I can't do it because there's going to be too many body bags, and that's not proportionate, and it's going to escalate. And Bolton said that's the most irrational thing he's ever heard from a president, and this was the turning point when Bolton knew he was going to turn on Trump and not defend him anymore, and he knew at this point that, like, oh, when I'm done with this, I'm going to, like, write a tell-all book and expose how evil and bad and wrong Trump is. So, let's understand that. The reason, as I told you, the reason Bolton hates Trump is because in his mind, Trump is not hawkish enough. This is why you do not give credit to anybody who utters an anti-Trump sentiment. Because the reality is, as bad as Trump is, there are plenty of players on the right who are even worse! Even worse! On the actual issues, on the policies, on the substance. And this is not a defense of Trump, by the way. Trump has been abysmal. Trump has been terrible. Trump's, you know, policies over his time in office have been devastating. But a guy like John Bolton, the reason he's mad is because in his mind, Trump is not hawkish enough. Trump is continuing the war in Iraq. Trump is continuing the war in Afghanistan. Trump increased drone strikes by 432%. Trump is escalating with Iran and Venezuela right now. Not enough for John Bolton. He wants more body bags, more death, more ground invasions. And that's why he's mad at Trump now. So if the so-called liberal media is cheering him, that says a lot about them, doesn't it? You got to be focused on the issues or you lose your way in this personality clash and the partisan politics. And there's nothing dumber than that.